and open a saving. And you just double click on here. And enter username and password. And yeah, what is my object? My object is how to create the accounts group, how to create the accounts group in SAP. So what is the path for creating accounts group and what is the T code? T code is OBD4. T code is OBD4. And what is the path? SPRO, financial accounting, and general ledger accounting new, master data, GL accounts, and preparation, define accounts group. Very, very simple. Let us see how to create. And do one thing, go to SPRO, enter SAP reference IMG, and financial accounting new. Go on mute, please. General ledger accounting. Master data. GL accounts. So this one, preparation. This one here. Define accounts group. What is the T code? OBD4. How to find the T code? Go to additional information, additional information, display keys, IMG activities. The last four digit is the T code, OBD4. Either you just come to path and double click on here. You just go back, what is the T code? OBD4. When you go to through path SPRO financial accounting like that, otherwise straight away here you need to enter T code. What is the T code? OBD4. Press enter. See this one, like this. This is the shortcut key, transactional code. And click on here new entry, enter here your chart of accounts. What is our chart of accounts? Yesterday I created. Our chart of accounts is GMOC. See this one, GM operational chart of accounts. Yesterday I created. And enter here accounts group. Enter here any four digit. It may be numerical or it may be alphabets. Let it be. And I am entering here SHCA. What is meant by share capital? Enter here any four digit and write the description. What is the description? Example, share capital, and from number to two number. From number 100000 and two number 10999, like this. Okay, this is the chart of accounts. And accounts group, any four digit, it may be numerical or it may be alphabets. And write the name, share capital, from number and two number. Do one thing, how the system will map, you just concentrate here. In the enterprise structure, I can create company code. In the enterprise structure, I created company code. In this company code, I assign to chart of accounts. I assigned to chart of accounts. Yesterday I assigned assignment of like do one thing. See here. Yesterday I did one option. What is this? See this one. Assign company code to chart of accounts. Assign company code to chart of accounts. And now I am doing under this chart of accounts I can create accounts group. How the system will understand? Go there. See here, whenever I am creating accounts group, here I am specifying this accounts group belongs to which chart of accounts. Here I am specifying the chart of accounts. It means this accounts group I am creating under this chart of accounts. And later I will explain you. And under this accounts group, I will create GL accounts. Under this accounts group, I will create GL account. What is the GL accounts? Example, rent, commission paid, cash. Those all are the GL accounts. GL. And under this GL accounts, I will post accounting entries. Under this, I will post accounting entries. Like rent account data to cash, commission paid account data to cash, cash account data to commission received, like that. So where I can create the GL? In this level, under this accounts group. And here I can post accounting entry. Here value should be updated. Based on accounting entry, value should be updated. And based on this value, we can generate the reports. Got it my point? How the system will map. First, you can, in the enterprise structure, I can create company code. Under company code, I want to create chart of accounts. Under chart of accounts, I need to create accounts group. And under this accounts group, in the future, I will create GL accounts. Based on these GL accounts, I can post accounting entries. When I post accounting entries, the value should be updated. What is the value for rent? What is the value for commission paid? What is the value for like different GLs? And based on this value, we can generate the reports. Okay, this is the mapping. Okay, now you just create like accounts group, chart of accounts and all. Here you can change your chart of GM, OC. So better you just select here, Control C, paste it here. So what is that? Reserves and supplies from this number to this number. Secured loan, this number to this number. Example, sundry creditor, this number to this number. This number is not mandatory. Whatever number you want to give, you can give, but don't miss the sequence. Okay, and later for fixed assets, and see this one and click on here, down, paste down. click on here save and back. Any doubts, anyone regarding accounts group?
What is come to?
Oh, sir.
Sorry?
From account to account, is numbers mandatory?
No, see this one. At the time of
liabilities one, starting from.
Let me complete. At the time of chart of accounts creation, as I specified 6. Did you remember yesterday class? I specified 6.
Yes, sir.
Yeah. And here I can give any number between 6 numbers. Example, see this one.
Okay.
You just zoom once. So how many numbers is there? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. From this number to this number, you can give, means you can give any interval, but don't exceed of 6 digit.
Okay.
Just give any interval. For example, whenever you want to, for example, in the future, you want to create Ramesh Capital, example, you want to give Ramesh Capital GL account. So what is the account number? What is the number range will be reflected? 100000 will be reflected. Later you need to, you want to create Suresh Capital account. What is the number will be reflected? 100001. And later you need to create another capital. Example, Naveen Capital. What is the number will be reflected? 100002 will be reflected. But here you need to give any interval, any from number to two number, you just give any number. Based on this number range, the number will be reflected when you create the GLs.
Okay.
Example, do one thing. Example, this is other income. This is other income. So what's the number I gave? 320000. 329999. This one.
Okay.
320000 to 329999. You just give any number range but don't exceed of 6 digit. Okay. And
okay.
For example, when I create commission received, what is the number will be reflected? Example, 320000. And later I can create rent received, and what is the number will be reflected? 320001. Okay, later I can create miscellaneous received, any income. Like this this number range will be reflected. Why I am creating number range? Future, whenever you can create any GL based on this number range, one number will be reflected. Okay, and commission received means 320000. Example, I am saying commission received. Any GL, when you create any income GL, this number will be generated. Why? Because we are creating GL under this accounts group. Okay, got it my point?
Okay.
Naveen? Yes. Naveen, right?
Yes, got it, Naveen.
Are you speak louder, yeah, please?
Yes, Vingat, I got it.
Yeah, someone is asked doubt. Who? Okay. And later, do one thing. The next one, note it down. Next one. Define retained earning account. So what is mean by retained earning account? See, first you just listen. We have, do one thing. See here. We have two accounts. Example, we have two accounts. Profit and loss account. And balance sheet. Listen carefully. Profit and loss account and balance sheet. In the year end, go on mute please. Some sound will come. For example, see this one. We have profit and loss account and balance sheet. Every year end, we will move the data. It means, for example, after completion of profit and loss account and profit and loss account, the net loss or net profit. Net loss or net profit will be generated. What happened? This net loss or net profit is moved to balance sheet. Right? Is this correct? When you create the profit and loss account, finally net loss or net profit will be generated. So this net loss or net profit is moved to profit and loss account to balance sheet. Okay, and see, now do you just people catch the point? What is meant by retained earning account? Means retained earning account is helped to move the data profit and loss account to balance sheet. Got it, my point, everyone? What is meant by retained earning account? Retained earning account is help to the move the value profit and loss account to balance sheet. Okay, see here, when you got net loss, this is deduction from the capital. When you got net profit, this is adding from the capital, right? And note it down. You people note it down. Save and back. And what is, you see here, what is the path from creating retained earning account? See here, SPRO, I will tell you notes. SPRO, financial accounting, and financial accounting, general ledger, master data, GL accounts, preparation, this one. What is this? Define retained earning account. You just double click on this document. It is explained what is meant by retained earning account and all. Here you want to write, see here, see, at the end of the year, the system, you just read this one, everyone, you just understand this point. At the end of the year, at the end of the fiscal year, the system carry forward the balance of profit and loss account to retained earning account, means balance sheet. Okay, you can write like this, everyone, you please note it down. At the end of the fiscal year, at the end of the fiscal year, please note it down. At the end of the fiscal year, the system carry forward the balance, the system carry forward the balance at the end of fiscal year, the system carry forward the balances of profit and loss account to balance sheet. Profit and loss account to balance sheet. Profit and loss account to balance sheet. Retained earning account is to help retained earning account is to help the data, to help the system to move the value profit and loss account to balance it. To help the system move the value profit and loss account to balance sheet. Done, completed. Yeah, in the down you just note it down, note, you please note it down, one note, 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 note. Basically, this is year-end activity. Basically, this is year-end activity. Basically, this is year-end activity. But as per the SAP suggestion, but as per the SAP suggestion, we want to do at the time of implementation. We want to do at the time of implementation. Basically, we want to create one GL account. Retained earning account GL account under this group. Which group? Under reserves and surplus. We want to create one GL. Example 110000 number will be generated. Now I don't want to create any GL. Later I will create. And I am reserving one number 220000 for retained earning account. Later I will create the GL. So see this one, how to assign this GL to retained earning account. Everyone, you just catch the point here. What is the path? SPRO. Go on mute please. SPRO and financial accounting new, general ledger accounting, master data, GL account and preparation, define retained earning account. I reserved one number 220000. In the future I will create the GL account. What is the GL account? Retained earning account. Okay, what is the T code? OB53. In the future I will create the GL. Okay. Sunil, go on mute please. Enter here SPRO. Enter SAP reference IMG. Select here financial accounting new and general ledger accounting and master data, GL accounts, preparation. See here, define retained earning account. You just double click on this and here you can enter your chart of accounts. What is your chart of accounts? GMOC. See this one, GM operational chart of accounts. Under this chart of accounts we have groups. See this one, profit and loss account statement and account. Here you need to enter X. Here you need to enter X. X means any value. It may be like net profit or net loss. And here you can enter account means GL account. What is the GL account? I reserved this number 220000 and you can copy to here. In the future I will create one GL and based on this number, that number is called retained earning account. See here, this is your operational chart of accounts, GM operational chart of accounts. And what is this? This is the transaction BIL. BIL means balance carry forward. And enter here X. It may be loss or it may be profit. And enter here your GL number. Then press enter. Enter button in the keyboard. Press enter. When I press enter, one pop-up will come like this. What is this? Account 110000 not created in chart of accounts. Still I didn't create GL account. That is the reason it is showing this message. No problem. And ignore and click on here save. Save and back. The next one. Noted. Next one. What is the next one? physical year variant. Physical year variant. So what is mean by physical year variant? Physical year variant nothing but financial year. Physical year variant nothing but financial year. What is the Indian financial year? Indian financial year is April to March. And 12 periods, right? 12 periods. And what is the financial year of America?
Jan to December.
And what is the financial year for Singapore? Example, June to July, I guess. I believe June to July. Same thing follow China also. June to July. This is Indian financial year and this is American financial year, Jan to December, and this is Singapore or China financial year. Like different countries follow different financial years. Okay. So what is meant by fiscal year? Fiscal year means we need to create financial year. Okay, concentrate here. As for the SAP, we want to define 12 fiscal year periods and 4 special periods. Why you need to create special period? Special period you need to create for auditor purpose. For example, after completion of your financial year, one day auditor will come. He will audit entire financial year and he will create financial statements, then he submit to the government. So when I enter four, after completion of your financial year, up to 4 months, any day auditor will come and verify. Means April to March, next year April, May, June, July. Any day the auditor will come and verify. When I create two special period, after completion of your financial year, up to 2 months, the auditor will come and verify entire documents of April to March, and he design financial statement like profit and loss account and balance sheet. When I enter special period 1 and after completion of financial year, auditor will come up to 1 month and he will verify all the documents. So what need to understand here? We need to create financial year 12 normal periods and 4 special periods. Actually every company follow 4 special period. So why you need to create 4 special period? We want to create 4 special period for auditor verification purpose or auditor auditing purpose. He will audit all the books of accounts. Got it my point? Everyone, are you understand? This is the normal for accounting entry posting purpose. This is auditor purpose. This is normal periods and this is special periods. And go to SAP, see here. Maintain fiscal year variant. So what is the path? SPRGO, financial accounting new, financial accounting global settings, ledger, and fiscal year and posting period. Maintain fiscal year variant. So what is that? OB29 is the T code. OB29. Let's go to through path. For example, slash and go back. Please understand. Now my question is, how to create financial year in SAP? How to create financial year in SAP? I think within one minute its meeting will be end. You joined again. And what is my question? My question is, everyone, are you able to hear my voice?
Yes, yes, sir.
Yes, yes. Yeah. What is my question? My question is, how to create financial year? How to create financial year in SAP? How to create financial year in SAP? So go to through path, see here. Otherwise, you can enter T code. I'm going through path for your understanding purpose. Enter your SPRO, enter SAP reference IMG and financial accounting and general ledger. Sorry, financial accounting, global settings, financial accounting new, financial accounting, global settings, ledgers, and again see here. Fiscal year and posting period, and first one, see here, maintain fiscal year variant. What is the T code on that?
OB29.
T code is OB29. What is the path? Financial accounting new, financial accounting global setting new, ledger, and fiscal year and posting period variant. The first one, everyone, you just catch the point. You just double click on here. When you want to know more information, you just double click on this document, okay? And when you want to create, you just double click on this timer. Double click on this timer. See this one, SAP suggests some lot of standard fiscal year. When you go down, SAP already created some standard fiscal years. See this one, V6, July to June and 4 special period. Number of postings means number of months 12, and the number of special periods means 4. And do one thing, see this one, V3, April to March and 4 special periods, and 12 normal period and 4 special period. SAP is already created. If you want to use this V3, you can use. Otherwise, based on this V3, you can create your own fiscal year. Everyone, you just catch the point here. We have two types of fiscal years in the SAP. Everyone, catch the point. You have two types of fiscal year in the SAP. One is year dependent, one is year independent. What is meant by year dependent and what is meant by year independent? Year dependent means whatever fiscal year you can create, that fiscal year applicable only particular year. For example, do one thing. When a example, year dependency. I created a financial year, example 2022 and 2021, April to March. Year dependent is work only 2022, 2021. Next year again I want to create financial year if it is dependency year. And what is meant by year independent? Year independence means when you create the financial year 2022, 2021, 2022, 2021, the next year onwards automatically fiscal year applicable subsequent year. Once when you create as a year independent, the fiscal year automatically generated 2021-2 and 2022. And later next automatically generated 2022 and 2023 like that. So when you create year dependency, this is applicable only this year. Next year again you want to create financial year. When you create as a year dependency or year independency, when you create dependency, this is applicable only particular year. When you create as a year independency, that is applicable subsequent year also. Next year, next year, next year, automatically generated. So how to create year dependency and how to create year independency? Okay, see here. At the time of fiscal year creation, at the time of fiscal year creation, when you activate, when you click on this radio button, when you click on this radio button, this V3 now year dependency. When you remove this tick mark, now this is called year independency. Okay. And what is this calendar year? If it is Jan to December, if it is Jan to December, you need to click on this radio button. Okay. If it is not Jan to December, don't click on this. If you use standard V3, you can use. Otherwise, select your V3 and click on your copy as. Click on your copy as. You can create your own financial year. Click on your copy as and enter your any 2-digit. Example, G3, our G3 and April to March and 4 special period. When I click on this radio button, this is year dependency. Means this G3 applicable only 2022, 2021. When you don't click on this radio button, now this is year independency. This is applicable subsequent year also. And if it is Jan to December, you just click on this radio button. If it is not Jan to December, don't click on this radio button. And this is 12 months and this is 4 special months. The as you need to say, explain your client will be suggest if it is 4-2 whatever. Okay, why you want to create special periods? This is for auditing purpose. Then click on here, press enter button in the keyboard and copy all, then click on here. Okay, so G3 for your own purpose and V3 for standard one. If you can use V3, you use, no problem. And if you want to create your own, select your V3, then click on your copy as and enter here any 2-digit. Press enter button in the keyboard, click on here save. April to March and 4 special period, 12 months and 4. If you click on this, this is year dependency. Don't click on this year independency. Click on here save and back. Anyone, any doubts?
I have one doubt here.
Yes, please.
Actually, for example, one company fiscal year first, when the company has started, they thought fiscal year should be there in a dependency. Okay, based on dependency we have created the fiscal year variance. After year completed, they want to extend the companies in till 5 years, 6 years. So we can change
if your question is how to move year dependency to year independency, right?
Yes.
Very simple. Simply you just remove this tick mark. When you click on this year dependency, when you remove this tick mark, this is year dependency.
we can do this in a
means
real time experience also.
Yes, real time only. Do one thing, concentrate here. When you click on here this radio button, this G3 you can use only for 2022-2021. Okay. And when you remove this tick mark and this G3, you are able to use 2021 and 21-22 and 22-23 and 24-25, like that, subsequent year. Got it my point? When you click on this radio button, this V3 is used only this year. When you remove this tick mark, this G3 is next year, what, how many years you can use it. Okay,
got it.
The next one is this one. Assign company code to fiscal year variant. Assign company code to fiscal year variant. Why I want to assign this fiscal year to company code means the system will understand your company follow which fiscal year. Like, is this April to March? Is this Jan to December? Is this July to June? Which fiscal year want to follow your company code? Okay, that is the reason you need to map, or you need to link, or you need to assign company code to fiscal year variant. Basically same path, go to SAP, same path, the next one, see this one, assign company code to fiscal year variant. What is the T code? OB37. Okay, simply double click on this. And click on your position, enter here your company code GM10, press enter. This is your company code, right? And here you need to assign fiscal year variant. What is that? G, see this one, April to March, G3. So system will understand this company code follow April to March. Okay, for example, when I assign V6, what happened? System will understand. Example, when I assign V6, system will understand this GM20 follow July to June. Like, system will understand. That is the reason we are mapping, or we are assigning our standard G3. Click on your save. The next one, see this one. This one is completed, right? The next one, we said global parameters, right? The next parameter is define variant for open posting period. For example, see here, concentrate here. For example, do one thing. For example, I have 1 to 12, right? 1 to 12. At the time of this configuration, define variant for open posting period. When I enter 1 to 12, I am able to post accounting entries entire year, April to March. Or instead of 1 to 12, when I enter, example 5 to 6, what happened? April is the first, April, May, June, July, August. Means I am able to post only August to September. That's it. Means you can control accounting entry postings. So when I enter only 1 to 1. What happened? The end user able to post only April month. When I enter 1 to 2, what happened? End user is able to post accounting entries April and May. Got it my point? You can control accounting entry postings. That is the reason we need to create these two objects. Define variant for posting period and series one, the ninth step. Open and close posting period. These three steps. These three steps is very important. The first one is define variant for open posting period and assign variant to company code and open and close posting period. And what is meant by open and close posting period? Example. What is this month? For example, just imagine this is April month. I can enter only 1 to 1. This April is completed. What can I do? I can enter 2 to 2. What happened now? The end user unable to post accounting entries in the April. End user able to post only in the May month. April is the first month. May is the second month. So example, May is completed. What can I do? I can enter 3 to 3. What happened? End user unable to post May month. End user is post only June month only. Like when you enter 1 to 12, end user is able to post entire year. So what need to understand here? This is control accounting postings for months. Anyone? Any doubts? Naveen, Renuka and all. Everyone?
No doubts.
No doubt, right? Yeah. And go to this. The first one. Define variant for open posting period. What is the path? Same like... I will tell you path for your understanding purpose. I created this Excel. What is the path? SPRO, financial accounting new, financial accounting global setting new, ledger, fiscal year and posting period, define, define variant for posting period. So this is the path and this is the T code, OBBO. You just listen careful. I am going through path. Everyone, you just catch the point. So what is my question? How to create define variant for open posting period in SAP? Either you can go through this T code or either you can go through this path. Like SPRO, enter SAP reference IMG, financial accounting new, general ledger accounting, financial accounting global settings, ledgers, and this one, select year fiscal year and posting period, this one, select year posting period. First one, define variant for posting period. What is the path? Once again, financial accounting new, financial accounting global setting new, ledgers, and fiscal year and posting period. And posting period, the first one, define variant for posting period. What is the T code? Additional information, IMG activity. OBBO. You just double click on here and click on here new entry, enter here any 4-digit and write the description. Okay, enter here. Example, I am entering GMPV and GM posting period variant. Okay, click on your save and back. Very simple. Enter here any 4-digit, write the description. That's it. Click on your save and back. Once again, very simple. You just double click on this and click on your new entry. Enter here any 4-digit and write the description. Otherwise, click on your position GMPV. See this one? This is I created GMPV. Click on your save and back. The next one, assign variant to company code. Assign variant to company code. You just double click on this and click on your position. What is your company code? GM10. This is your company code. GM Steels Private Limited, GM Cement Private Limited. Here you need to assign your variant. Just now you created GMPV. See this one? GM Posting Period Variant. And here also GMPV. Then press enter and save. The next one, open and close posting period. Very, very important. You please note it down one note. This open and closing period is month end activity. Write one note. Open and closing period activity is month end activity. Every month you need to do activity. And open and close posting period. What is the T code? OB52. Month end activity. Very, very important. Okay. You just double click on this radio button. Everyone, catch here. Very important. Double click on this. And click on your new entry. Click on your new entry. Enter here your variant. What is your variant? GMPV. What is this? GM posting period variant. And see here. And click on here this details. Note it down. Everyone, you just catch the point. What is the short name? What is the short name of assets? Short name means A. As per the SAP, A means asset. This is the interview question actually. Okay. A. What is the short name of asset? A. What is the short name of customer? D. D means customer. K means vendor. M means material. S means GL. And V means contract accounts. Actually, this is the interview question. Short names. What is meant by K? K means vendors. What is meant by D? D means customer. Okay, this is the short name as per SAP. You just click on your plus. Plus means all accounts. Plus means valid for all. This is called accounting type. Accounting type means A, accounting type, asset. D, accounting type, customer. K, accounting, vendor. M, material. S, GL, like that. When you click on star, it's all. See this one? From 1 to 2 and 1 to 2. Example, see this one. Example, I'm entering 1 2020 to 12 2020. What happened when I enter 1 to 12? Means end user is able to post entire year. Okay, when I enter 1 2 3, what happened? End user is able to post only April, May, June. Why? Because I specified only 1 to 3, but I specified 3 to 5. What happened? End user is post accounting entries only like June, July, August. That's it. For practice purpose, you can set 1 to 12 and 4 special period and 13, 20, 20, 13, 14, 15, like 16, 4, right? 16 special periods, 20, 20. Anyone? This 13 to 16 for auditor purpose and this 1 to 12 end user accounting entry posting purpose, and this is the variant. Then click on your save. You please understand the mapping here. This is the variant, right? This is the variant. Do one thing. You please understand the mapping here. First I can create variant. What is that variant? GMPV. I created this variant, right? And this variant you can assign to company code. What is that company codes? GM10 and GM20. And at the time of open and closing period, I specified this variant. Open and closing period, I specified this variant GMPV. So what happened here? When I specified GMPV, at the time of accounting entry posting of company code GM10 and GM20 is controlled. The end user is want to post accounting entries in the GM10 company code. This company code reflected based on this variant. Why? Because first I can create this variant, and this variant I assign to company codes, and at the time of year open and closing period I specified this variant, and based on this variant this is the months 1 to 12 or 1 to 1. Example 1 to 1. What happened when I enter 1 to 1 and all the company codes, company code 1 and company code 2, in this company code 1 and in this company code 2, end user is able to post only April month. Why? Because I specified 1 to 1. Or either I can enter 1 to 12. What happened? And in this company codes, end user is post entire year. This is the mapping. You need to understand this. Variant I created, I assigned to company code, and at the time of posting and close, I specified this variant, GMPV. Then click on your save and back. Okay. And so this one is completed, right? Remaining thing I will tell you tomorrow. And do one thing, this Excel document I will share you everyone for practice purpose.